Hi, we're Nick and Valerie Wisniewski on behalf of expertvillage.com. We're here to talk about animal tracking, and for more information, you can visit our website, walnuthilltracking.com. We're going to talk about how to measure an animal's track. When measuring an animal's track, we use a tape measure that's measured in inches. We don't use the metric system, but if you have some data, you can obviously convert the data if you wish. We start with measuring the width of an animal's track. And using a tape measure, we like to not use the metal tab because there's some inaccuracy that is there. It's not much, but it is a little bit. So we'll actually start with the line on 1 inch, and we'll put that on the outside edge of the animal's, one of the animal's toes. We'll lay it directly over. And when we're looking at the track, we want to make sure we're looking straight down, not from an angle, because that will distort it. Looking straight down, we want to find the floor of the animal's toe, which means the absolute bottom of the toe as it made contact with the ground. So putting the one there, we'll lay the tape carefully over the top of the track. And over here on the other toe, looking straight down, we find the floor of the toe, and we will take a measurement there. And so we get a measurement of about 1¾ inches wide. Next, we want to look at the length of the track. When measuring the track, we include the nail marks. Here you can see there are nail marks in the front of the track. We want to include those. And at the back, we're including the heel pad. On canines and cats, this metacarpal pad we call the heel pad. So we're going to measure from here to here. As we did with the width, we're using that 1 inch line, coming all the way back down here, looking straight down at the track, and we'll get a length of about 2½ inches. Knowing the length and the width of an animal's track will help you determine what species left the track on the ground.